It's a way of the Mr. Quickie, oh yeah.
In 1992, Meryl Streep, Goldie Hawn, and Bruce Willis starred in a film called Death Becomes Her. The idea for the film was pretty clever, however lacking in execution. The film follows two rivals, Streep and Hahn, over the course of decades. During that time, Hahn's fiancée Willis, a revered plastic surgeon, is seduced and stolen away by Streep. Hahn is crushed and spirals downward into a life of severe depression and uncontrolled binge eating. Years later, Hahn shows up looking absolutely amazing, like she hasn't aged a day. Having taken a magical potion to stop the aging process, she hasn't. And I know what you're thinking. No, I have not taken that potion. It doesn't exist. It's made up for the film, but thank you. Willis is seduced back by Hahn, and the two reunite, plotting to kill Streep so that they can be together. But what they don't know is that Streep has discovered the potion and taken it herself, which actually brings life eternal. Once ingested, the potion makes death impossible. So when Willis finally pushes Streep down the stairs, she does indeed break her neck, but she doesn't die. Her head merely sits backwards on her shoulders. Willis's skills as a plastic surgeon come in handy, and Streep is returned finally to normal, or at least semi-normal. After Streep and Hahn battle it out in Act 2, they both realize just how valuable Willis is, and they try to get him to take the potion as well. I won't spoil the ending for you, but I will tell you that at no point in this film does anyone ask Willis what he's talking about. Of course, this is not such an original idea. There is a very similar story in the New Testament Gospel of John. A risen Jesus, who has obviously taken the potion, appears to his disciples and shows them the wounds he suffered during his crucifixion. This leads to the story of Doubting Thomas, who was not there for Jesus' original visit. He was making English muffins at the time and later told the other disciples that he won't believe, quote, unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands and put my finger in the mark of the nails and my hand in his side, I will not believe. Jesus appears to the disciples 1 week later and Thomas is there this time. Jesus tells him, I want you inside me. And Thomas obliges, putting his finger inside the wound to Jesus' side, which later becomes horribly infected. Good thing he drank that potion, right? What becomes clear from this story is that however one dies, the wounds suffered will be part of your resurrected body, just like Jesus. If you were decapitated in a terrible car accident, you can expect to be carrying your head around for all eternity. If you were blown up by an IED in Iraq, you're going to need some help getting around in the afterlife. God and his people might brag about him being all-powerful, but apparently, just like the iron chariots God can't defeat in battle, our wounds are not something God has the power to heal. Even after death, even for his own son/self. Which explains why he can't grow back the limbs of our wounded warriors or other accident victims. I would assume that our psychological traumas are immune to God's powers as well. Which means I will never cease being traumatized by hearing My Heart Will Go On, or the memory of that second grade trip to see the ice capades with my classmates. But there's still one question that baffles me. How does anyone believe this nonsense? Once again, I'm me. Thanks for watching.